Even a highly skilled driver can be subverted by an unstable design. Nemo's Nemesis is just flat out hard to drive. Under all that armor, it's a three-wheel design, two powered wheels and a trailing caster. It's easy to turn, but tough to drive straight. So if Nemo gets stuck in the sand, he'll be sunk. Under the hood, Pangolin has powerful motors and 10-inch drive wheels. He's engineered for victory. Back to you.
Thanks, Dan. Rolling in on the right is Andy Chen's Nemo's Nemesis, and to the left is Mike Adkins' Pangolin. Pangolin's glass breaker is actually on a mechanical arm that can raise or lower as needed. Sounds like the labyrinth stomach is rumbling. Soup song! Bon appetit, robots.
Robots ready.
Nemo's Nemesis is going through the saloon door. The rats are out now. No problem as Nemo's Nemesis turns toward the box. Great Rat is trying to cause problems as Nemo's Nemesis pounds into the 253-pound obstacle here. Oh, Great Rat gets lifted up there. Penguin still sits at the rear speed bumps.
He's stuck on it. Gets a nudge from the Great Rat there, but his ground clearance will cause him problems in this event.
Oh, stand by the spikes. Penguin has to wait to regain his wheels. Now with Goots Cross. Gonna see if we can get that glass breaker to work. Not quite strong up there. Gonna turn it around and back into it. Oh, and he knocks the glass free. Got the break, but it still gets Mike 15 points. Nemo's Nemesis has almost cleared the box. He slips through backwards, and Nemo's in at 15, Dan.
Nemo actually cut off the outside of his wedges for a narrower profile, which helped him get through that gap.
Pangolin going for the suspension bridge. He's down. Oh, and he's stuck there.
He didn't take the cue from his earlier clearance problem on it. The longer your robot is, the more ground clearance you need to get over this dip. He's resting on the front and back end of his robot. His wheel's not even touching the bridge.
A big opportunity for Nemo's Nemesis here. He was down 30 after the gauntlet. It's tied so far in the labyrinth. Time to make up some points. The rats don't cause him too much grief. Oh, he's flipping those wedges almost like a warning. Great Rat backs off. And now Red Rat starts protecting Pangolin.
This could be a blessing in disguise on it. One good hit, Mike's robot might get pushed free.
Mike's still working those controls. Red Rat hits him again. Looks like he's moving, and he's up! Red Rat kind of a dual personality going on. The evil critter actually helps out.
Of course, Pangolin will have to get back across the bridge, and I'm not sure he's capable of it. He'll need a lot of speed. If he can take out the glass and soar across at the same time, Mike will have saved himself.
He's got that glass breaker up. Breaks the glass. Oh, but he gets turned sideways, and those tires are spinning once again. Nemo's Nemesis, meanwhile, heads over to the ramp. Is he going over backwards, or is he heading for the sand? Got those wedges up. He is going for the ramp. He times it, and he's across. 20 points, that ties him again with Pangolin here in the labyrinth. Two obstacles to go, and Pangolin is still stuck on that bridge. Here goes Nemo's Nemesis, back across the ramp. He's moving. Oh, almost tossed headlong there.
Those wedges saved him, Ahmed. If they're down, he lands on his face and it's all over.
Mike can't stand this. He can see Nemo's Nemesis still running, but he's going nowhere. He does still have an overall lead of 30 points, but Nemo's Nemesis has time to catch up.
He's avoiding that sand, though, Ahmed. He knows how tricky it would be driving through there, but the only thing left is the rollers, which are also tricky for a two-wheeled robot to handle.
Pangolin, meanwhile, being nudged by the Red Rat again, but I don't think he'll get the same results this time.
Nope, the rat can't pull, and in fact, it looks stuck itself. Mike and his son have to root for that clock right now.
Tough break for Pangolin, but time is running down. There's the siren. Nemo's Nemesis is heading for the gates. We could have an interesting situation here, Dan. That bonus paint is 30 points. If Nemo gets it, we have an overall tie. Both could get to advance the fight to the finish. Andy Chen is fighting for it here. He wants a shot at that fight, and the glass is so close.
I'll bet you can hear that motor straining right now. The wheels just aren't getting the power they need to get the gate down. He's going backward, trying to concentrate his pushing power into the single point of that tail, but I'm not sure he has enough juice left.
He's turning around now. Nope, and he's turning back. He's got the right angle. Looks like his bot will just fit through those gates if he can nail it here. But now it doesn't even look like he's moving. Has he lost power? Great Rat's giving him the what for. You can see Andy working it there. Now he's moving. The time's about to expire. He's at the edge of the turntable. And there's the buzzer! So near yet so far, Nemo's Nemesis almost pulled off a great comeback. Andy is obviously disappointed in the great round, but Mike Adkins hangs on for the victory.
Ahmed, I thought Penguin's stable 6-0 design would secure him the victory, but that long body nearly proved to be his undoing. Nemo's Nemesis tried to take advantage and rack up the points. He even survived a nearly fatal mistake at the foot ramp, but in the end, he just didn't have the power to complete this come-from-behind victory.
It's a tie! Both bots walk away with 35 points, but Penguin had more points going into the event, so he's moving on to the fight to the finish. Tanya's standing by with the winner as we speak.